Hello everyone, do you know what microgreen is? Well, today I am going to tell you about that. Microgreen, as the name suggests, is composed of two words, micro and greens. Micro means small and green relates to plants. So these are the small plants but packed with nutrients. These microgreens have more nutrients as compared to the matured green leafy vegetables that we consume. So today I am going to tell you how we can grow microgreens, what different seeds we use for growing microgreens, what are the different medias in which we can grow and how to grow that. So here we are conducting lot of research also on microgreens, as well as we are promoting these technologies by growing microgreens at our managed urban garden. As you can see in this tray, this is the potting mix which we say, and these microgreens can be grown in four different medias, which potting mix is one of them. Potting mix, we add soil and vermicompost in the ratio of 1:1. So as you can see here, we have a lot of varieties here, like we have the white radish, red cabbage, mustard, pink radish, pak choi, broccoli, fenugreek, amaranthus, cauliflower and cabbage. There are many more which we can try at our homes. So I'll just start with the first media, that is potting mix. First we have to take a container, fill this to the 3/4 level, and then we have to take the seeds. I am taking this fenugreek seeds, and we have to pour this fenugreek seeds or any seeds that we want to grow densely. The seed density for microgreens should be high, means the seeds should be spread close to each other like this. So as you can see here in this tray, we have already spread the fenugreek seeds. Now we have to thinly cover these seeds with the remaining potting mix mixture, and you should see that these are properly covered. So this is how the tray will be after covering it with the seeds. We can lightly sprinkle it with water. This we can leave it for germination also. From the 10th day onwards, the microgreens are ready for harvesting. As you can see in this one, this also is a microgreens which is ready to harvest. Microgreens, whenever we want to harvest, always use a scissor for that, and do not cut from the bottom length. Just it is a 3 to 4 inches height, we have to take cut it in that way. Very carefully we have to harvest these microgreens. Microgreens are used as a functional food, and it is used commonly in the form of chutneys, smoothies, as a dressings, toppings for burgers, sandwiches. So you can see these are the microgreens which is ready for harvest, and we can cut it in this way and consume. This is our second media, that is coco pit. These coco pits are now readily available in online stores, and we can get it readily. So we are going to see how to grow microgreens using coco pit media. This is all coco pit. There is no mixing with of any other thing in that. Here at Manage, we are doing research work also on microgreens, where we are analyzing the nutrient composition of these microgreens which we are growing here as a part of the research project. So after spreading the seeds all over the surface, we are again going to cover it thinly with the leftover coco pit. These microgreens are highly rich in beta carotene, vitamin C, most of the water soluble vitamins, and these we have established through our research which we are doing in collaboration with National Institute of Nutrition, NIN. So this is how we have to cover this with the remaining coco pit, and again we can have to sprinkle little water over it. Next we are going to see how to grow microgreens in tissue media. Tissue media, we can take any tissues like which we commonly use in our kitchen or even kitchen towels that is available or any such things like this. We can put it like this on the tray. Then we have to sprinkle little water over this to make it damp. So just ensure that these tissue papers never dries up. It has to be kept constantly moist, but not too much water also should be sprinkled. Otherwise these tissues may get spoiled. After this, same way we can spread these seeds all over the tissue paper. Ensure that these seeds are also densely placed over the tissue paper. So this is how we can spread the seeds like this, and after this we need to sprinkle water again. So this tray is now ready for germination. This is the fourth media in which we can grow microgreens. This is not simple normal tap water that we can use from our kitchen tap or anywhere else. So this is only water, no other nutrients in this. So we can take any containers like this, fill it with water, half level of the water layer like this. I have taken water here. You have to take another mesh container like this, which is having mesh like structure so that can be in contact with water. And also we have to use a mesh. As you can see, this mesh is also there. We have to sprinkle seeds over this mesh and just keep it in the water like this, sprinkling cabbage seeds. This water we have to change every 2 days or preferably every day if possible also. Simply we have to lift this basket like this and change the water and again place it over the water. So this is how the seeds will be there, and these are so fresh which can be cut as and when we need it and use at home. So it is easy to practice, easy to grow. This is day 7 grown mustard microgreens. So as you can see, the microgreens have come up so well. So we don't require any other thing in except water, and these are so rich with nutrients that it is of emerging superfoods as well as the functional foods which have lot of health benefits also, particularly for the cardiovascular diseases, diabetes and all. These have a great potential to cure the diseases. So friends, we can see that all the four medias that we have demonstrated today, this is the one we had used using potting mix. This one is using cocoa pit. This is tissue media, and this is hydroponics, that is only water we are using it here. So these microgreens, they are simple, low cost, nutrient-full, packed with nutrients, and they are health, have a lot of health benefits and nutrients also. Though it is micro greens, but these have having macronutrients, and that is the importance and significance that these are gaining a lot of attention in the developed nations. And here in India also we are gradually realizing the significance and importance of these microgreens.